Oh, hello, darlings. So nice to see you together. Steve, I don't want to spoil your lunch, but this is rather important. I think I'm going to be arrested. I am terribly sorry to embarrass you with all my little problems, Steve, but, well, you've always been so good about legal advice to my charities and my committees.
Vera, I would have been most upset if you hadn't turned to me. Now, what'll you have to drink?
Oh, double brandy straight.
Jean?
No, thanks, Steve. Excuse me, Clara, I'm sure you'd rather speak to Steve alone.
I would prefer you to stay, dear. This does concern you too.
Me?
The halfway house we were going to set up. I'm afraid I've let you down. It'll all have to wait.
All right. Now, you tell us why you think you're going to be arrested.
My company's brought in external auditors. It's a relatively small firm, but highly profitable. I'm the major shareholder. My family left it to me. I was the only one with a head for figures. I'm a qualified accountant, you see. The other investors are friends. Very wealthy, of course. It's really more of a little sideline with them.
And?
Hmm?
Well, you were saying about the external auditors.
Well, I suppose my friends thought it was all getting too much for me, and I was given an assistant. A very bright young man. Too bright, in fact. It's a pity. Well, when he discovered a few discrepancies in my books, he suggested we call in the external auditors. Well, I am a director, I know, but what could I do? I had to agree. I was outnumbered.
Doesn't every company have external auditors?
Oh, mostly public companies, dear. The shareholders had a vote some years ago and let me handle the books. Now, this had to happen.
Just how much money is involved, Claire?
Oh, Steve, I don't know.
Well, I'm sure if it's only a question of a few mistakes, a little bad accountancy.
Bad accountancy? It was brilliant. Well, not quite brilliant. I am being found out.
Do you mean to tell me that you've been deliberately fiddling the books?
Well, yes, I suppose I have. I can't deny it.
But why?
I needed the money.
You need the money?
Of course. Good heavens. You don't imagine I kept it to myself. All that money that I have been donating to my charities over the years, where do you think it came from? I couldn't possibly have afforded it out of my own purse.
God, they feed you earlier in here than they did in the last place I was in.
Just as long as you eat it, Mrs. Smith.
Well, I haven't been waited on since I was at the Monarch Hotel. Oh, boy, was that a day.
Special occasion?
My husband thought so.
Oh, second honeymoon.
No, I shot him.
I brought you those magazines you asked for.
Oh, thanks, you are a doll.
Just a minute.
God, I don't know what the heck she thinks you're smuggling in.
Just checking to see that the centrefold's still there.
Oh, God. Now I know what they mean by splitting your side laughing.
I'll be back to give you your sponge later.
Here, why aren't you sending the young doctor that's been prodding at me?
Sorry, they haven't been giving sponges since Florence Nightingale. Good morning, Miss Bennett.
Well, Vera, couldn't keep away from me, eh?
Obviously, you're feeling better, Smith.
What? I feel like I've been stabbed in the guts.
They say you're doing very nicely.
Yeah, well, they sew you up real well in here.
There's no reason why you can't return to Wentworth soon.
Give us a go, Vera. I could do with another week in here. You don't want me stitches coming undone, do you?
You'll be transferred the day after tomorrow.
Please, not when I'm eating.
Where'd this come from?
Oh, I reckon they think I'm a charity case. Well, you know, if some of them get too many or they pop off, they give the leftovers to the needy.
Well, I'll be back to see you get to Wentworth in one piece.
Yeah. You do that.
Could I have a word with you?
I was so sorry to hear of your injury. I thought the cyclamen would brighten up your room. If you have a minute to write, I'd love to hear from you.
Rich old trout.
And talk about a hypocritical sham. Saying that she was giving the money to charity? I bet. She'd probably get most of it for herself. And it's not as though she even needs the money. It's just pure, unadulterated greed.
Well, why are you so upset, then?
I have to tell Karen that the halfway house isn't a go.
What's that got to do with Karen?
I mentioned it to her. Once she was released, she was going to run the place.
Jean, you can't go round building up these girls' hopes when there's the slightest possibility that things could go wrong. I mean, it just makes my job that much harder.
Well, come off it, Meg.
Oh, let's just drop it. I'm not in the mood. I just want to go home.
The girls are never going to believe it when I tell them I was tucked in by a cop.
Oh, we're almost human. Oh. The nurse is on her way.
Ooh. I'm going to be glad to get back to my own bed. At least I won't be watched over 24 hours.
Sorry, regulations.
Yeah.
Do you get on well with the other women?
I run them. They're almost human too.
Even the one who stabbed you?
She was next screw. They're different. Oh.
You'll get a good night's sleep after you take this. Oh, not uncomfortable, are you?
Oh. She'll be right.
The tea trolley's waiting outside.
Thanks.
Anderson out.
Oh, I don't feel so good, Miss Bennett.
What's the matter? Well, then report to sick call. Come on, Lizzie, hurry up.
He's still feeling sick, Miss Bennett. She should get sick more often.
Yeah. Hey, maybe it's catching. I mean, she'd be nasty enough to do that.
I just feel crook, that's all.
Well...
Oh, I don't know. I wish Bea was here.
Well, I don't. It's her fault I lost all my privileges.
Yeah, well, I reckon she's better than Monty.
You got her or that Bourke woman, and she's a desperate woman.
Yeah. She scares me, you know, Lizzie.
Oh, g'day, 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 g'day.
Oh, morning, Monty.
Hey, how about you two giving us a hand to put that Bourke bitch in her place?
What you got in mind, Monty?
Doreen?
Can't you forget it?
Forget? Ah, oh, get a load of you. Listen, if I let her get away having me stuck in solitary, she'll think she's got me over a barrel.
Yeah, well, Bea would try and keep us out of trouble.
You don't reckon I'm as good as Bea, Doreen?
You'll be Smith's roommate, aren't you?
That's right.
Guess you two were pretty buddy-buddy.
Try to get along with people.
So you'd go along with Bea giving Ferguson the run of the place?
I'm not on anyone's side if that's what you're trying to get at.
Yeah, that's what I heard about you. Miss Goody Two-Shoes. Think you're above people. That's okay. Just keep that pretty little nose clean. I won't have to break it for you.
Karen Travers? Miss Vernon wants to see you. I haven't finished with you yet. Now, you've already caused enough trouble by accusing Ferguson of being responsible for Anne Yates' death. That sort of behaviour ends here and now.
Whatever you reckon's a fair thing.
Anderson, Birdsworth, you can come back later.
Oh, send Lizzie away and you won't get her back for a week.
Yeah, we've got to have a shower before breakfast, miss.
Oh, all right then, but don't take all day.
Hello, Noeline.
What do you want?
Nothing. I was just wondering how you was going. I reckon that was a real funny joke you played on Monica.
Yeah?
Okay.
Yeah.
Doreen obviously doesn't know which side her bread's buttered on.
Yeah, gone mouldy.
She's got more up top than you stupid cows.
Just cut it out. Get a move on.
Hey, Lizzie.
Oh, I can't get this man. Oh, it's been ticker. I can't breathe. Oh, let me get some air.
Why don't they just let her drop dead? Who'd miss her?
Yeah. I'll get your shower ready, Noeline.
Keep moving till I catch my breath.
To get the doctor, Lizzie.
No. Just a bit dizzy. I'll see the doc after I catch my breath.
What's happened?
Oh, she's had a bad turn.
We're all funny.
What's going on?
Help! All of a sudden.
Come on. I can't leave Lizzie.
Oh, you pull this trick once too often, Lizzie.
Oh, Kerry. Get away from this.
The door unstuck and was jammed.
Yeah, poor thing. It was getting pretty hot in
there. Oh, just shut up, will you?
What's going on in here?
Our little band of comedians thinks this is funny. Come on, you better get to a doctor. Feeling better, are we, Lizzie?
You lot can forget privileges for the next week. Now get out.
The thing is, we were relying on a large contribution from a certain quarter. And with that gone, but that doesn't mean that we won't be able to get the money from somewhere else. It'll just take time. I'm sorry.
Time doesn't seem to mean that much anymore. Oh, have you heard anything about my going to uni? Now for the good news.
Well, these things do take
time, yeah.
The governor's put the suggestion forward to the director of corrective services. So we'll just have to wait and see.
I'll be the one doing the waiting.
Steve, it's happened. I knew it would happen.
All right, Clara. All right. Come and sit down. Let's just talk this whole thing over quite calmly.
Calmly, says. My head is on the block, about to be chopped off, and he said calmly.
I take it that the auditors have discovered your little embezzlement, huh? All right. Now, if I'm going to help you, you're going to have to tell me everything.
Everything?
Well, how you managed to juggle the books, for one thing.
That was quite simple. I made out checks to bogus companies for incoming goods and signed the goods received advices.
For goods that didn't exist.
That's right. Now the fraud squad is going to come and pick me up.
Clara, now I'm sure that if we go and see your fellow directors, after all they are friends of yours, it probably won't take the matter further, particularly if you offer to reimburse them.
It's not as simple as that.
Why is that?
Well, it is a little more than the few thousand I mentioned yesterday.
How much is it, Clara?
They discovered a discrepancy of $75,000.
Oh, I see. Well, that certainly is a little more than a few thousand. Still, it's not impossible for you to arrange, is it?
Well, they're bound to find out in the end that it's, how shall I put it? Just the tip of the iceberg. To be precise, Stephen, it's $254,780.
I'd say you're healing very nicely.
Must be those gentle hands of yours.
An inch to the right, and even my gentle hands would have had trouble patching you up.
Oh, I guess somebody up there's looking after me.
You'll be a bit uncomfortable for the next few days until the stitches start healing properly.
Hey, Doc, any chance you'd give me something to knock me out? If it hadn't been for that pill last night, I wouldn't have got a wink of sleep.
All right.
So by tomorrow, Bea'll have things sorted out.
Take a while before she's back on her feet, bud.
At least it'll put a stop to that Noeline woman.
It's me who'll put a stop to her, not Bea. And I'm still in charge till she gets back.
Oh, yeah, sure. But we can forget about the fight now, can't we?
Biops in 5 minutes, girls.
Oh, great. Fat lot of good that's going to do us.
Well, it's nobody's fault but your own.
Oh, Mrs. Jackson, I was wondering, I know I've got to be punished in that, but couldn't you give me something else? You know, like scrubbing floors. But nothing too tough, because I'm feeling real crook. And I can't wait another week for me lollies and stuff.
I'm sorry, Doreen, but you're going to be punished the same as everyone else.
Oh, come on, Mrs. Jackson, you know she hasn't got a brain in her head.
Forget it.
Jeez.
Never mind, Dore, all screws are alike, hard as nails. God, I don't know where I'm going to get me fags.
Karen, You're still allowed to go to the buy-up, aren't you?
Yeah, there's nothing I want.
Oh, I remember when I was a little girl, after me mum ran off, me dad used to buy me lollies, you know, for a treat. That was when he was sober. Then he'd always take them back again.
He was an animal.
Oh, but I figured if I ate them all down at once, well, then he couldn't take them back. I was four then. Anyhow, I've been hooked on lollies ever since. And I thought, seeing that you were going to the buy-up, you might be able to get a few things for me.
All right.
And me.
What do you want?
Thanks.
Okay. Hey, Travers, you're not a social worker yet, you know.
Mind your own business, Monica.
Cop her. Oh, come on, Doreen, you don't want your hand out from her.
Yes, I do.
Well, they told me you're appearing in the magistrate's court tomorrow.
How nice of you to come, Steve. They didn't waste much time, did they? How could my friends do this to me?
You are looking at an awful lot of money, Claire.
They could afford it. They haven't missed it for the last 5 years.
Just exactly how much did you keep for yourself?
I gave it all away.
Mm-hmm.
No, that's not quite true. I kept $3,000 a year for myself. But I made sure that it came out of my share of the company's profits and nobody else's, so I was only really diddling myself.
What am I going to do with you, Clara?
Steve, when I think of all the people who are relying on my support...
I wonder if I could use Robin Hood as a precedent.
I don't think he was excused either.
Come on. I'll take you home.
Vera, there's a detective from consorting to see you in the governor's office.
Consorting?
Is this anything to do with Anne Yates's friends? I know you've been seeing them. Look, if you're in any sort of trouble, what?
Move along. The lunch bell's gone.
Hey. Oh, great!
Come on. Oh, your blood's worth bottling.
Oh, yeah,
what you got for
thanks.
Me, Dory?
Nothing.
Reckon I could do with some fags, Lizzie.
They're mine.
Can't give.
Oh, look, Bea'll be back tomorrow, so you wait. You'd better watch it.
You're the one better watch it.
Oh, get lost, Noeline.
Thought I told you to keep your nose clean.
Will you girls please get into the dining room?
She wrote the letter to be handed to us in case of her death.
How does that affect me?
We thought you might be able to help us with this George Lucas.
He owns the flats I'm in.
You ever speak to him?
Sometimes.
Would you know where we could find him?
No.
How did you come to live in those flats, Miss Bennett?
I ran into Ann Yates. We used to work together. Well, at the time, I was thinking of moving, and she told me there was a flat going in her block.
I see.
What did the letter say about Lucas?
Enough for us to want to find him. Quickly. Anyway, that's our problem. Thanks for your time, Miss Bennett.
Thank you. Well, this should do the trick.
Thanks for the tea.
Pleasure.
Oh. What are you doing, Bea?
Oh, I just want to get something off my locker.
I'll get it. What do you want?
Magazines?
Thanks.
Oh, yeah, Tuck. Is there another one there with a green cover, one I haven't read? That's it. Thanks very much. Oh, there you go.
Get you a glass of brandy.
Bea.
Didn't think my legs would make the distance.
What have you done?
I got your note. I thought I'd answer it in person.
You've got to go back, Bea.
No way.
Oh, Judy, this is...
I know who it is, Gran. What's she doing here?
Why don't you go back to bed, dear?
No, I'm staying.
Oh, you should be in hospital.
Nah, I'm all right. Haven't even dropped a stitch. Look, I didn't mean to drag you into this, Mum. But you're about the closest, and the cops will be checking out all my old mates.
What makes you think they won't come here?
Because there's nothing to lead me to, Mum, that's why. If they checked out everyone I'd done time with, they'd be kept busy for years.
You can't be sure.
Judy, I just want to flake here a couple of days.
What are you going to do then?
I'll think of something.
If you're caught here, Gran will end up back in prison.
Judy, will you go back to bed, please? She's right. I'll find somewhere else.
No.
We'll talk about it in the morning. You need to rest.
Thanks, Mum.
With Lynn.
Oh, that's Sid Butterfield's son.
Well, he owns the nursery where Lynn works, doesn't he?
No, the father does.
Oh. I received a call from the police last night. B. Smith escaped from hospital.
How?
She managed to slip some sleeping tablets into the policewoman's tea.
Well, at least the prison won't be held responsible.
It's the only good thing about it.
Well, she won't get very far in her condition.
Were you speaking to Vera yesterday?
Yes.
I thought she seemed a little bit disturbed.
Well, I think she's still a bit off colour.
I don't want her overdoing it. She's down for night duty tonight.
I think she'll be all right.
Morning.
Good morning. Morning.
First-class honours,
I probably won't get a job.
Well, I could never study all of that. Oh, well, you get used to it, you know. I'm doing my thesis on strains of Corynebacterium michigalense relating to capsicums and tomatoes.
Oh.
Yeah, basically it's the study of the death of a capsicum through particular strains of bacterium. I never want to look at another capsicum as long as I live.
It's about time you got here.
Oh, I didn't think I was late.
You're not. Hi, Dad. See ya.
Look, Jeff, Lynn can make it here under her own steam. She doesn't need you to pick her up and drop her off.
Oh, it's no skin off my nose, Dad.
You're seeing too much of her.
Hey?
You heard me.
Oh, come on, what's put all this on?
Look, son. I've nothing against her. She's a nice girl. I know her family too. And, well, I'm ready to overlook what she's done. But look, son, you're doing honours at uni this year. It's a big year for you. You can't afford to get involved with a girl. Look, you've only got one chance to get through your studies. I can't afford to put you through another year.
Dad, I'm not getting involved with her. I just like her, that's all.
Well, it could lead to something else.
How? She has to go back to the prison every night. I couldn't invite her out even if I wanted to.
Yeah, well, she won't be in there forever.
Okay, Dad. What if it does develop into something?
Put me foot down, that's what.
Yeah, here comes the crunch, doesn't it?
That's right. Look, Jeff, you're my son. I want the best for you. When you get through, you'll have a position to uphold. That'll mean a girl and a wife who you can be proud of.
God, now you got me married.
I'm looking to your future, Simon, which is what you should be doing.
Look, I'm old enough to choose my own friends
I'm
to make...
I'm still your father, and you'll do as I say.
To hell with that.
Don't you swear at me, boy.
But you can't run my life forever.
I'm trying to help you, boy, the best way I know how. Jeff, come back. I haven't finished yet.
You never finish.
I've got some work to do at the university. I'll pick you up this afternoon.
Was that about me?
No, it was about me. Making up my own mind.
Oh, Jeff, I don't want to cause trouble between you two. Your dad's been really good to me.
Well, it's just a matter of principle. That's all.
Looking forward to Bea coming back, eh?
Oh, don't cry. Don't cry.
Doreen.
It never hurt anyone.
Did it?
There's only one animal in here.
Yeah. So why don't you own up?
Well, what are you waiting for? Why don't you go ahead and get it over with? Well, won't you, because you're too cowardly? You're not big enough to stand on your own 2 feet, are you, Monica? You have to get other people to do your dirty work for you.
Yeah, you tell
her. And you do something like that because you can't face anyone out in the open. You're too sneaky. You're pathetic. You two want to go ahead and kill each other. Fine. Just leave all of us out of it. Do you want me to see if I can fix him for you?
Pay attention, please.
No doubt you will find out sooner or later from the press. B. Smith will not be returning today as was expected.
Oh, she dropped dead.
She escaped from the hospital. She will be caught eventually, we have no doubt about that. However, should any of you see this as an opportunity for causing trouble, I warn you here and now, it will not be tolerated. That will be all.
Who did that, Doreen?
It is believed the woman is dressed in a brown and white floral frock and cream cardigan, which was reported stolen from a ward close to where the prisoner was last seen. She is described as violent and dangerous. Anyone seeing this woman is advised...
We can't let her stay here, Gran.
She won't hurt us, Judy. I know what it's like when you first get out.
But this is different. She's wanted by the police.
You've got no one to turn to. You're lonely. Scared. That's what makes you desperate.
Gran, if we call the police now, we won't get into any trouble.
I wouldn't do that if I were you.
I don't want Gran going back to prison.
And you can keep your nose out of it. Now, stop it, both of you. You're welcome to stay here until you're better.
Oh, you, Gran, you can't.
I've made up my mind. Well, I know it was to be expected, but to be brought to trial. What will people think?
Well, the thing we have to do now is to get you out on bail.
Oh, it's an awful lot of money, Steve.
It could have been worse, Clara. Now, who do you want me to see to organize finance for you?
I haven't a penny. To put it crudely, I'm broke.
Perhaps we can organize a loan. You must have plenty of collateral in the house.
Double mortgage.
Furniture, car, paintings.
To the hilt.
Jewelry, then?
It's paste. The first days, it's the only thing that's totally paid for. Besides, it wouldn't be enough.
All right, then, what about your friends?
Steve, if they had me arrested, they'd hardly like to turn around and pay my bail.
Family?
A
second cousin in England. Seems as though I'll have to spend my remand in prison.
Well, there must be some way. I'll see what I can do.
What's it like in there, Steve? No bed of roses, eh?
No, Claire.
He's been through a lot, you know. Dad gave him to me one Christmas. Must have won at the trots. It's the only thing he ever gave me that he didn't take back the hock for booze. He's the only real friend I ever had at home. I never took him on a job with me. Sounds dumb, eh? Well, I knew he was a bear in that, but I just didn't want him to see me doing something wrong. I took him along with me and Frankie, you know, when we went over the wall, because I just couldn't leave him behind in here. And I reckon he understood about Frankie and me anyhow.
She's asleep. Oh, Judy, dear, please try to understand. I can't send her away. But I promise I'll try and talk her into giving herself up.
You know what'll happen if she's found here?
Yes, I'm not being fair to you, am I? If anything happens to me, there's you and the baby.
Gran, you should be worried about yourself, not us. If you end up back in prison, it'll kill you.
No. No, it'll all work out. Hello?
Jean Vernon here, Mum. Is everything all right?
Yes. Yes, of course. Oh, I'm sorry. I forgot. I was meant to come and see you this morning. Yes, well, I wasn't feeling very well. I didn't go to work. I slept straight through.
You're sure everything's all right? You haven't been working too hard?
No. No, just a little rundown, that's all. I'll come and see you as soon as I'm better, if that's all right with you. Yes, thank you. Thank you. Goodbye.
If you do go and see her, you better be careful she doesn't find out anything.
Got a minute?
Sure.
Anything the matter?
Oh, no. It's just that I wish I'd found an easier job for Mum.
Well, what made you think of Mum?
Well, she was supposed to check in, and I rang her. She's not feeling very well. Now, Meg, I know what you're thinking. You promised no more going to see Mum.
I still think it's a silly rule. I mean, what harm is there in an officer visiting an ex-prisoner?
It's probably there to protect the prisoner. Persecution and all that.
I know. Anyway, what I wanted to see you about. Have you spoken to Noeline Bourke?
I tried to once, believe me. That was enough. How do you get through to women like that? Hello. Oh, well, tell him that I'll come and fetch him. See, Butterfield's here to see me.
Lynn Warner's office.
Yeah. I hope there's not another problem. Hasn't Lynn been working out, Mr. Butterfield?
Now, look, I don't want to get her into trouble. She's a hard worker and a good kid. I just want her out of the nursery. You know, I mean, perhaps you could find another job for her somewhere. I wouldn't want to see her left high and dry.
Well, have you told her?
No, I reckon that'd be best coming from you.
Well, I'll have to make out a report, so I do need a reason.
Well, it's my boy, Jeff. He's a bright kid. He's got a good future ahead of him. Something I didn't have. And I don't want anything ruining it for him.
And you think Lynn could?
I've his young ones myself. She's attractive, needs looking after. I don't want my son thinking she's the one for him.
All right, Mr. Butterfield, I'll let Lynn know.
Look, I don't want to make it any rougher on the kid, but my son comes first.
They told me you're on night shift, so I took the punt.
What are you doing here?
Answer your question. I got bored in those sleazy little rooms. I can't stand to be cooped up. How about a drink?
Okay. Have you seen any of your friends?
No. It's best to keep clear of them for a while.
Ann Yates wrote that letter, George. The police came to see me. They wanted to know if I knew you or if I knew where you were.
And what did you tell them?
Just that I'd met you a few times, that's all. They didn't tell me what was in the letter. They just said that they had to find you.
And they will. You got a call on, love?
Who?
The cops. If they think that you've been helping me, well, I'm not going to have you involved. We don't even know what's in the letter yet. If they assume that you're helping me, they could even tie in with my business. You've got to turn me in, love.
Yes, he just left a minute ago. Something to do with my lease. No, I didn't tell him. He's just gone downstairs to his office. Right.
Good girl.
What'll happen to you?
It'll take more than a letter from Ann Yates to convict me.
You too.
Cheer up. There's this social Sheila just come in on remand of fur and everything. I heard Mrs. Jackson reading out the charges. She's up for pinching. No wonder she's wearing the fur, eh?
Ta-da! Good as new.
Oh, geez, thanks, Karen.
Thank you.
Yeah.
You ought to take more care of your things, Doreen.
If you come near him again, I'll kill you.
Oh, yeah? You and the plastic surgeon.
I'll let you all introduce yourselves.
Hello. I'm Clara Goddard.
Here you're in for pension money, huh?
Well,
It's not quite as it seems.
Innocent, huh?
Oh, no, no. I did take some money, but I didn't keep it. There is a slight difference.
How much did you get away with?
A little over $250,000.
You little beauty! Hey, Lizzie, cut this run.
But when you leave here, where will you go? You said yourself the police will be watching anyone they think you might turn to.
Well, I just need the money to get away. I don't have to show up in person.
Well, then how will you be able to get the money?
There are ways.
No, B. You're not going to get Judy to run your messages. I won't allow it.
Now, you don't want me to overstay my welcome, do you?
What do you want me to do?
Gran, you're not going to help her anymore. Haven't you done enough already?
I think Mum can make up her own mind.
Well, I won't let her. I'll call the police.
Like hell you will.
Judy. I mean it. If you give us any more trouble...
If you tell anyone I'm here, you're going to be putting Mum right back inside. You expect anyone?
No. Quickly, get in there.
You better watch it.